Let's take a look at a solution very quickly. The first thing we have to do is add in a new column to the crew members table definition. I'm going to scroll down a little bit and find where the crew members table is created right here. I'll then find the comment for to-do number one. But right after that, on a line 22 or so, we're going to add in a new column. This is going to be a foreign key column. It's going to reference the ID column on the boats table, and we're going to call the foreign key column boat underscore ID. This is what is going to relate a crew member to a boat. So we're going to put in here boat underscore ID, integer, and then references boats ID, like so. So remember, the keyword references means that this entire column is going to reference some other column in another table. We then write out the name of the table and then the actual column inside there. Well, that is it for step number one. Now we'll take care of step number two. We now need to write out a query that is going to fetch all the crew members that are associated with a boat that has an ID of number one. So we're going to put that query down here at the very bottom of the file. So down here, we will write out select star from crew underscore members, and then we want to find where all or where the boat underscore ID property is equal to one. We'll say where boat ID equals one. And that should be it. So let's go ahead and check our solution, see how we're doing. All right, looks great. We've got these two crew members who are assigned to boat ID 1. Well, I hope you had some success here. If you didn't, as usual, don't sweat it. So many locations in this course, you're going to be practicing the same ideas very frequently. Because at the end of the day, with SQL, we end up doing a lot of stuff many times over. So let's pause right here and move on to our next topic in just a moment.